In this video, I'll show you two ways you can track file downloads in Google Analytics. We'll cover the steps to enable and check if downloads are being automatically tracked. I'll show you how to track downloads using Google Tag Manager, and we'll walk through how to report on your file downloads. The easiest way to track file downloads is to use the enhanced measurement feature in GA4. This will automatically track when people click to download a file on your website. Let's head to GA4 to take a look. To check if downloads are automatically being tracked on your website, we need to navigate to Admin. Then we select Data Streams in the Property column. For my GA4 demo property, I have a single data stream, but if you have multiple streams, you will need to check each one. Okay, so let's open the stream. And let's select the configuration icon under Enhanced Measurement. At the bottom of the list, we can see File Downloads is enabled. This tells us that we're automatically tracking the files people are downloading from our website using the File Download event. Google has a pre-configured list of file extensions that will be tracked automatically. So let's head to Google Support article to check out which files will be tracked. This support article documents all of the events that Google Analytics can track automatically using Enhanced Measurement. And scrolling down, we can see the file download event. In the center column, we can see the regular expression that is used to match file extensions. This matches all of the most common files people are likely to download from your website. This includes PDFs, Excel documents, Word documents, text files, presentations, CSV files, compressed files, video files, and audio files. Now let's test out the automatic download tracking. To do this, we're going to use Tag Assistant and the debug view in Google Analytics. Let's head to Tag Assistant. To open Tag Assistant, you just need to navigate to tagassistant.google.com. Now we enter the URL of our website. And click Connect. Our website loads. And now we can download some files to test things out. Okay, now let's head to Google Analytics. We're still in the admin area, so let's select Debug View in the Property column. Because we're using Tag Assistant, we can use the Debug View to preview all of the events we're sending to Google Analytics. We can see the file download event that has been automatically collected using the enhanced measurement feature. We can select these to view additional information for each download we clicked. The file download event will automatically track 6 additional pieces of information using parameters. This includes the file extension, so you can report on the type of files people are downloading, along with the file name and details about the full link to the file they downloaded. Let's select the file extension parameter. We can see this is tracked that we clicked a PDF file. And now let's select the file name parameter. This shows us the path along with the file name and file extension. You can also check the link text, link URL, and other link parameters depending on how the files have been linked on your website. Now let's take a look at the other file download event. Selecting File Extension shows us that we clicked to download the Word document. And again, we can select File Name to view the path and file details. In most cases, the automatic tracking available with Google Analytics will give you everything you need to report on the files people are downloading from your website. In a moment, I'll also show you how to configure your own file download tracking using Google Tag Manager. But first, let's take a look at how to report on the files people have downloaded from our website. Since Enhanced Measurement automatically collects an event called File Download, you can view this in the Events report. However, taking the time to create a custom exploration report lets you view all of the details we saw in the Debug view. So let's navigate to Explore. And let's create a new blank report. Let's name the report File Downloads. I'm going to increase the date range for my report. Now we need to import the dimensions and metrics we want to use in our report. So let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. Let's search for File, and let's enable the File extension and File Name Dimensions. If you want to report on the URLs people click to download your files, you can also use the Link URL Dimensions along with Link Text, Link Classes, and Link ID. But I'm not going to use them in my report. Now let's click Import. Next, we need to click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for and enable Event Count. And let's also search for and enable Total Users. Now let's click Import. We can now add the dimensions and metrics to our report. You can double-click or drag them to do this. You will notice that there is a blank row in the report. This is because there are events and users that aren't associated with the download. So let's create a filter to remove this. Let's scroll down and add a filter. Let's choose File Extension and select Matches Regex as the condition. Now let's enter a full stop and a plus sign. This will mean we only include file extensions that contain at least one character. Now let's click Apply. Our report updates, and we're only including our file downloads in the report. Feel free to adjust the report and try out the different visualization options depending on how you want your file downloads to appear in Google Analytics. I'd love to know if you're going to create this report. Let me know in the comments. And if you found this helpful, please take a moment to hit subscribe too. Okay, now that we've covered automatic file download tracking and reporting on files people have downloaded, let's take a look at how we can track files using Google Tag Manager. Let's head to GTM. To track file downloads using GTM, let's start by navigating to Variables. And we need to enable the built-in click URL variable. To do this, let's select Configure to the right of built-in variables. Now let's enable the click URL variable. If it's already enabled in your container, then you don't need to do anything. Now let's close this. And now let's create a new user-defined variable. To do this, let's click New. Let's name the variable click URL file extension. Now we select Variable Configuration and choose Auto Event Variable as the type. Next, we need to select the element URL as the variable type. And then for component type, we need to select File Extension. This variable will automatically capture the file extension of the links people click. Okay, now let's save the variable. And let's create one more user-defined variable. Let's name this one click URL path. Again, we select auto event variable as the type. But for this variable, let's choose path as the component type. This will capture the page path people click when they download a file. And let's save the variable. Now we need to create a trigger, so let's navigate to Triggers. And let's click New. Let's name the trigger File Download. And let's select Trigger Configuration. Now let's choose Click Just Links as the trigger type. And we need to select Some Link Clicks. Otherwise, our trigger would fire our tag every time someone clicks a link. Now let's select Click URL File Extension as the variable. Then we choose Matches Regex, Ignore Case as the match type. And we need to enter a regular expression for the types of files we want to track. I'm going to paste the regular expression that Google uses for automatic tracking. However, you can customize this. For example, if you only wanted to track PDFs and plain text files, then you could simply enter PDF pipe TXT instead. Now let's click Save. The final step is to create our GA4 event tag. So let's navigate to Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 File Download. I've already created a variable with my GA4 measurement ID, so I'm going to select this. Since Google has an existing naming convention for tracking file downloads, I'm going to use this to create the GA4 event tag. So let's name the event file_download. Now let's select event parameters. And let's add 6 parameters. Let's name the parameters file_extension, file_name, link_classes, link_ID, link_text, and link_URL. Now we need to select the variables to pass the values for each of these parameters. For the file extension parameter, let's select the click_URL file extension variable. For the file name parameter, let's select the click_URL path variable. For the link classes, let's click the variable icon. Since the built-in click classes hasn't been enabled for this container, let's click built-ins on the top right corner, and let's enable click classes. Let's click the variable icon again for link ID. Select built-ins again, and choose click ID. Let's select the variable icon for link text. Select built-ins and choose click text. And for the link URL, let's select click URL. Now we need to scroll down and select the trigger we created for our downloads. Now let's save the tag. And let's click preview. Tag Assistant loads. We enter the URL of our website. And click Connect. Now we can click to download a file from our website. And let's open Tag Assistant. We can see our new GA4 event tag has fired. And if we select the link click event on the left, we can then select the tag. And if we have values selected on the top right corner, we can see values that have been sent to Google Analytics. So we can see our file extension, file name, and other parameters are working. How did you go? Is your event tag firing like my one? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And one really important thing to remember is that if you still have enhanced measurement enabled, then you will be double counting file downloads on your website. To check this, let's close this and select the GA4 measurement ID at the top. We can see that there are 2 file download events, so we do need to disable the enhanced measurement file download tracking. Let's head back to Google Analytics to do this. We're still in the admin area, so let's select Data Streams and open our data stream. Now we click the configuration icon for enhanced measurement, and we can turn file downloads off, and click Save. Now we need to head back to GTM. And once you're happy everything is working correctly, you can click Publish. This will publish the changes we made in GTM to track file downloads. You will now be tracking file downloads into GA4. Apart from tracking file downloads, there are even more ways to understand what people are doing on your website. You can use events to track all of the different actions people perform. If you're ready to learn more, then check out my GA4 and GTM courses. And please take a moment to subscribe to this channel. You'll learn even more ways to understand your audience and take your business to the next level. So please make sure to hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you in my next video.